Hi guys, welcome to my guide on how to become a true Sejuani beast. My name is Gedra and I've been an OTP Sejuani player for 4 seasons now. I've played Sejuani on both EU and NA accounts and I've reached Platinum with her. In this guide, I'm going to show you how to use her spell efficiently, how to gank a jungle early path that will help you clean your jungle faster so you can get right before the scuttle spawn and get the level 4 if you kill it. And we will see which item you should build on her to make her really strong and dominate the meta. So without further ado, let's begin. So first we have Sejuani passive, which is Fury of the North. Her passive has two abilities. The first one is Frost Armor. It gives her more armor and magic resistance, and it breaks 3 seconds after fighting an enemy or a jungle monster. The second one is Icebreaker. It applies only when the enemy is a permafrost with an E or ultimate, so we will talk about it later. Her first ability, her Q, is Arctic Assault. It's a dash, so you want to use it to escape through walls, to gank, or to get close to your enemy. So Sejuani's Q can be used to cancel enemy abilities, but you can also use her Q Flash to surprise your enemy in a gank or if you want to catch someone. You can also pass most walls, even the hardest one, with Sejuani's Q. Our W consists of two swings. Our first one will move enemy minions and monsters, so you want to use it when you jungle with Sejuani to push the monsters to the next camp. It will save you some time. Our second swing slow your enemies and it applies both on champion enemies and monsters. You want to use it to slow your enemy so you can apply your permafrost stack. Both swings apply permafrost stacks. Sejuani's E is her permafrost. It's an ability that frosts your enemy for 1 second if you can apply 4 stacks on Sejuani's permafrost. Sejuani can apply permafrost stacks using our W, our auto attacks, but also allies auto attacks. So you want to play with melee champions in order to apply permafrost stack easier. If you frost your enemy, you want to stay close to him in order to apply a burst of damage with Aftershock. Last Sejuani ability, her R, Glacial Prison, is a long range ability that will stun your enemy for 1 second. If you land your ultimate at 400 range for your target, it will create an ice storm that will slow every enemy inside and do damage after 1.5 seconds. If you touch your enemy in less than 400 range, it will only stun your enemy like permafrost. Here are some of Sejuani's most known combos. The first one is our Q. You want to be in close range, then apply W to apply permafrost stacks and use two auto attacks to get permafrost. Here you want to use Sejuani's R and dash to surprise your enemy. This one is a full combo Sejuani. You want to get close with her Q in order to bump your enemy, then use one auto attack, then W to apply permafrost. You must have 3 permafrost by then. Then you want to use your E permafrost to stun your enemy, reset your auto attack and apply R in order to do the most damage possible. The last one is the same as the other one, but you want to be in the 400 range with your R in order to apply the ice storm. Now we have Sejuani items. With the new season 11, you want to start with Frostblade. It will give you a chilling smite that will slow your enemy. You want to get a flask, and I recommend to get the free wards because it will give you visions. You can also get an oracle lens. It will give you the opportunity to clear wards, and it will be useful in early ganks. In your first back, you want to get boots. But if you have enough money, go with Bami Sender because it will give you some damage and it's a really good item to start for. Get control wards towards jungle, towards the enemy jungle or towards objectives. Then your core items will be, I recommend upgrading with steel caps if they don't have much CC and are mostly AD. But if you have lots of CC, I recommend going with Mercuries. As your first core item, I recommend highly to go with Sunfire Aegis. This item makes tank really really strong, so it's a must have for Sejuani. Then you want to go with Bramble Vest. I don't recommend upgrading it to Thornmail right away, but you can keep it in order to get the effect that will reduce healing from enemies. Then I recommend getting War Mugs. It's a really great item with lots of HP and HP regenerations. If the enemy has a lot of crits, you want to get Randuin. If they have a lot of auto attackers like Vayne, you want to get Frozen Heart. And you want to finish Thornmail after. Against AP champions, I recommend going with Force of Nature. If they have consistent damage, you can go with Spirit Visage if you have a lot of healing in your team and if you want to increase Warmog's healing. The last one, Abyssal Mask, is a great item if you want to burst an enemy with your team. It will be really great in team fight if you can lock an assassin or an enemy AD carry or AP carry. Then you have support item. If you have lots of dangerous assassin, you want to take Knight's Vow in order to protect your AD carry. Gargoyle Stonebait has been a bit less effective than the last season because before it gives you size and a boost of HP based on the enemy. Now it gives you a shield. I still recommend taking this item, but I would prefer more armor or more magic resistance. The last item is Frostfire Gauntlet. It's also a mythic item that can be used and replaced instead of Sunfire. This item is like Frozen Gauntlet, so you can still use your auto attack to slow your enemy. It also increases your champion size and will give you HP. I still recommend getting Sunfire, but this item can be a really good alternative. For Sejuani early jungle path, you can choose ever to go with 3 camps or you can go with 5 camps and scuttles to get the level 4. As you see in the video, I'm going to do 5 camps and then getting the scuttle. If you are fast enough, you will be right in time to get your scuttle, get level 4 and then gank a lane or counter gank your enemy jungle. You will have one level in advance compared to him. When you gank with Sejuani, you want to be behind your enemy. If necessary, you don't want to use your Arctic Assault. But if your ally bait your enemy, you want to be as fast as possible, so you want to get close to him with your Q. If you have the opportunity, just give the kill to the laner. That's the end of the guide. So guys, don't forget to like the video, subscribe for more Sejuani content, and I see you in the next video. Bye!